It's quite funny to move from the very serious three qualities of the first chakra. Diligence, orderliness, and patience. And to take a leap to three qualities of the second chakra, which give it almost like an immediate balance. It's very beautiful when we begin to realize that all of these qualities are within us, and together they enable us to fully cope with life, fully function as the human beings that we are. Then it makes a lot of sense, and it's not only funny, to move from diligence to humor. And humor is a feminine second chakra quality. When I say feminine, of course, it doesn't mean it is not related to women or men. It is, when we say feminine, it is in the left side of the chakra, where the more cooling energy resides. So to start our journey into humor and laughter, many years ago, I think it was around perhaps 16 or 15 years ago, when I went to teach in India, in the Himalayas, I met very beautiful liberated spiritual teacher, an Indian spiritual teacher. And we sat together for a personal meeting, and he described to me his process of enlightenment. And such a description you could never forget. He said, for nine months, I was laughing. Like day and night, only laughing, 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 laughing. Then, for 9 months, I was crying. Every day and night, crying, 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 crying. And then, for 9 months more, again, I was laughing, 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 laughing. And then, after that, no more tears, no more laughter, only silence. And such a, let's say, a simple way to summarize a process of transcendence. We'll put aside the part of the crying, although it will reappear in the journey that we will take today, in the experiential journey. And we'll stop to notice what a major part laughter played in this teacher's liberation process, transcending process. And it is true that whenever we have some not whenever, but often when we have some kind of a very liberating understanding, it causes us to laugh. Laughter is so often the direct result of understanding. Understanding that liberates us. Fragrance is an expression of transcendent state. But also the other way around. If we laugh and if we use humor, awaken humor in the right way, like we will do to today, I hope so, then we'll see how it can also lead to a liberated state. You see? So it goes both ways. We can connect to the freedom inside through laughter. And truly, only a free being can laugh and can laugh fully. And someone without humor, without laughter, cannot be really liberated. You see? If there is over seriousness, if there is heaviness, if there is rigidity, this is a direct indication, a clear indication of a limited state of liberation. You see? Mm-hmm. There has to be the added quality of humor. And why is that? Why, when we get to meet true enlightened beings, they always laugh, they always smile. It's a natural fragrance. And today I'm going to overwork you with smiling and laughter. So I hope you have prepared your jaws. Yeah? Okay, so it is because laughter and humor are, by their very nature, instant liberation. We need to understand that the whole pattern of human thought and emotion is the result of over seriousness. You see, our whole the very pattern of human thought and emotion is full of over seriousness. It's all about intense drama of our human life. It's like everything is dramatized. Everything looks deadly serious. And everything is full of, it is deadly serious because the human thought and emotion are all around calculation and worry and caution and control. Making sure all the time that everything is under control and worrying that things might not be under control. So this keeps us, of course, in a increasing state of over-seriousness. And so when we are over-serious, this must be an indication that we have lost touch with our transcendent state. Our transcendent state is characterized by the feeling or by our capacity to be, to meet and to face things in life from a non-attached state. You see, it's like we are high enough, free enough to treat things always relatively lightly. It doesn't mean that the things are not serious sometimes, but when they are over serious or when they are only serious, this means that we are starting to, let's say, take our drama in a complete disproportionate way, not from our true self, which can which always brings some lightness, some ease, and most of all, some inner smile. So you all got this postcard, I guess, and you can see in this postcard some guy laughing intensely, and above this guy in the so-called clouds, the gods are laughing with him. You see? So this is what we want to awaken today. It is the sense that the depth, the inner smile, and what is behind it. What is behind smile is freedom, liberation. Is this part in us that can instantly free us in the midst of a tremendously serious drama and connect us with the now, where we are finding this inner smile, not only of us, but also of the divine. So it says humor and laughter are like the best weapons with which the divine equipped us in order to defeat the deadly serious drama of our personal self. Our false self is made of this over-seriousness. And this over-seriousness keeps the self as the unquestioned center of the universe. When you direct this weapon toward your own pompous ego, it explodes with laughter. So, laughter is the killer of ego. And therefore, we don't only need to, you know, to wait for moments in which laughter comes, or when we watch a comedy that helps us. This is the power of comedy, because it has the capacity to show the ridiculousness of human drama. And then it releases all of our tension. It's like because everything looks so seriously. I remember a lot. I sound like, you know, a really old guy, like a 90-year-old. So I remember that as a schoolboy, managers in the school wrongly mistook me to be some mathematical genius. And they recruited me to join some kind of program only for mathematical geniuses. And of course I couldn't handle that, because I'm completely incapable of math. And And then I went to some kind of a private tutor to help me somehow manage this this new program. And she sat and she started explaining it to me, like she tried to show me some move, mathematical move. And at that moment, from that moment onward, for a whole hour next to her, I just exploded with laughter so intensely that I just couldn't stop it. She tried to speak and I was just laughing for 1 hour. Yeah. I just couldn't control it because my body resisted it so much that it had to find release, you see? So laughter is our inner hand that releases us from the cage of our over-seriousness, and which is, from another angle, is completely ridiculous, you see? Now, the thing with laughter and smile is that it's a quality that is very easy and fun to develop, right? It's like it's not like diligence, as we spoke 2 weeks ago. It's, you know, laughter and smile. But if we use it randomly, it will help us only to release tension. The great thing, and the moments when laughter and humor become a developed quality within us and take root within us, is when we train ourselves to laugh when it is least expected. Meaning, when we are completely taken by the over-seriousness of the drama, we are completely overwhelmed. And our thought and emotion tell us, be serious. This is the drama of your life. With laughter, you just jump out, you see? You just jump out, you connect to the now. What a gift of the second chakra. And laughter, in this sense, when we use it like this, is not meant to make us escape, you see? On the contrary, it is a declaration. It is a declaration, I am free. And I am able to meet from this freedom anything that comes my way. So laughter and smile can awaken in us great presence and great willingness, readiness to work with materials, the materials of life. And if you don't believe me, try it once. Even physically, when you are faced with a challenge, just physically create a smile, okay? A huge smile, like it will be difficult at the beginning, because surely you know how the over-seriousness clenches our jaws. You know when we're trying to to readjust our jaws because we clench our teeth and we tighten our jaws all the time. It is one of the most tense areas of our body. So it will not be easy at first. But if you manage to widely smile and look from that smile at the challenge, it will immediately seem different. Immediately. So even the physical willingness to do that makes us much more capable and supports our even other qualities, more serious qualities like courage, ambition, confidence, all of that. If it is all supported by humor, ironically, it gives us more power. So, with this in mind, we will start our journey. You still seem unconvinced and you look at me very seriously, but I will slowly melt away these jaws. Good. So first of all, we are going to enter now a three-stage journey. The first stage, we are just starting to get familiar with the quality. You see, because it's not just about talking, discussing the laughter and humor. We all know laughter and humor. It's not like we all have laughter from time to time and humor, but to meet it as a quality from within is very different. So let us start.